Hello, welcome to Glastonbury 2005. We are here, we do have power. We can bring you a programme of sorts, not the programme we had planned entirely. We'll give you a bit of a rundown of what's been happening today. You've probably seen it on the news. This was to be our set. There's a rec studio over there, which the weather has taken care of. I'll give you a guided tour of the mayhem a little bit later on. But we are here. It started a bit late, but the important thing is the event is up and running. We've got music. Let's have a bit of music straight away. Not so long ago on the pyramid stage, the main stage, let's hear from Elvis Costello. Elvis Costello on the Pyramid stage a short time ago doing Oliver's Army. So this fine palatial facility you find us in now is beyond the call of duty, industrious work of people who have been working far harder today than I have. Well, you won't find that difficult to believe. I've been sitting in the tea bar and the pub waiting for a call say we're ready for you now, which happened about a quarter of an hour ago actually. That's the kind of day it's been. So well done to those who've done the sterling work of rebuilding the studio from a ditch over there and reconstructing this for tonight's proceedings, and we'll see what tomorrow brings. But we'll be here throughout the weekend, and as well as performances off the stages, we're going to bring you our own live and intimate performance is right here. And who better to kick us off than Katie Tunstall?
My little pedal isn't working on this, Jules Holland, so let's do it acoustic. It's Glastonbury after all. Well, my heart knows it better than I know myself, so I'm gonna let it do all the talking. It's karaoke woohoo. Came across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse on a cherry tree. I felt a little fear upon my back, said don't look back, just keep on walking. The big black horse said look this way, said hell and day will you marry me. But I said no. Two. But I cut some cord and I shouldn't have done it, and it won't forgive me after all these years. So I sent it to a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. But it won't come back cause it's all so happy, and now I got a hole with a word to say.
Sounded great. You bailed us out with a trooper, Katie Johnson. Can we see Katie's feet?
Yeah.
See Katie's feet. Were you carried here in a sedan chair, in the sort of gold slingbacks and the woolen top?
Yeah, this is Glastonbury glamour, Mark.
It's a happening
look. It was actually the only shoes I could fit in my bag while I was walking around in my wellies. I thought, well, Glastonbury after all.
Well, that's great.
Make a bit of effort.
Absolutely. When are you on? When are you
tomorrow on the other stage at half two.
All right, great. We look forward to that. But well done for getting through. It seems kind of appropriate for this Glastonbury with what's been happening that the first song didn't work.
And you know, I think
that's the best start
work.
We could have had.
Yeah.
All right then. Katie Tunstall.
Cheers.
Black Horse and the Cherry Tree. Thank you very much. Right. So we are going to go to a film now because we were going to do a sort of scene set about Glastonbury and the effect it has, the impact on this small rural community for 1 month out of every year. So we had this sweet little idyllic film ready to go, and we had to update that quite late on. So have a look at this.
It is amazing, actually, to be honest. It really is.
It's just fields of nothing.
It's normally a very quiet village.
The cows are normally out. The wildlife's here, but there's no fence, there's nobody else.
It was just a normal Somerset village. It's only sort of 1 month of the year that you really feel like it's something special.
The first defence goes out.
You can see it moving a little bit further along every day.
Like that thing in China, you see it everywhere, like, you know.
And then within a few weeks, there's thousands of people here busily making the event what it is.
We've been painting the poles, we're doing all the festival poles.
Painting dustbins.
I think we're probably going to another 1,900.
Painting fences.
Got another week to go. Yeah. We're panicking.
Each day you look out and there's something else that's arrived.
It always feels a bit sort of weird this time. Yeah. It always feels like there's not enough happening.
It's the most amazing feeling of anticipation. It's the most wonderful, like a sort of a whole load of children waiting for a party.
And all of a sudden, whoosh, it's all there.
The roads get a lot more folk on them.
The traffic gets much busier, and then in the few days around the actual festival weekend itself, it's just stupidly busy.
It's only a small, tiny little village station, and it's suddenly turned into, you know, something like Bristol Temple Meads.
It's turning from a farm into a city the same size as Bath.
The place is full of people putting their tents up, their little flags going, this is my home.
The whole of that field, you see the way that it's over there, it's completely green. That's the field that they put the tents in, and it becomes completely blue. Amazing, amazing, wonderful party in the world, right on my doorstep.
Started at dawn, didn't it, really? And then it just pretty much went through to about 11 o'clock. So yeah, it's been pretty torrential.
Just behind the pyramid stage, the water level was up to the bonnet of the Land Rover I was driving.
Rivers running through Glastonbury.
No fishing, no diving.
I've been here 3 days now and it's gone from the sublime to the ridiculous.
Work there is totally great. Glastonbury's great, we love it.
Sounds
it.
I'd say most of these people really are prepared for it and all you need is wellies really. Wellies and a raincoat and you'll be alright.
So that gives you some impression of what's been happening today. I travelled down last night, having done a show in London with Brian Eno, which was a big thrill. And we were seeing the lightning forking down over Salisbury Plain. It was very impressive and quite spectacular. Not so welcome a sight, I suppose, if you're trying to set up your tent at the time. I should also point out that Glastonbury this year isn't going to be uncovered entirely by me on my own, though many might think that was a fair idea. But there are other presenters. Phil Jupitus and Joe Wiley and Lauren Laverne are out in the field. But such is the nature of the way things have gone today that we haven't been able to locate them, but we think we've touched base with Lauren Laverne and we'll hear from her very soon. A feature this year of the Glastonbury Festival is the John Peel stage in honour of, well, you don't need me to explain that to you. So hopefully after this we will hear from Lauren Laverne, who's up at the John Peel stage. But let's have music from that stage earlier on today. These are Maximo Park.
Me down. Oh, what's on your call? I'm here at the John Peel stage. Hello, couldn't hear you there. And it was called the New Band Stage previously, but obviously has been named after the man that everybody is missing this year. There have been all kinds of bands on here, all kinds of different artists. MIA, Maya just left the stage. She was amazing in the true tradition of John Peel. And obviously we all miss him very much as well. So we've put together a film about one of the most valued members of our team over the years.
As you know, this was the New Band's stage, but Michael Eavis and the good people at Glastonbury Festival decided to change the name and dedicate it in memory of the greatest DJ that ever was. That's why it's called the John Peel Stage. And so many good bands playing on this stage today. It's my pleasure to introduce the first band on. So please welcome on stage the Boyfriends.
John Peel had sort of been around here for years and years and years. So when he died, I thought, you know, one thing that we could do to pay him a real tribute and call the New Band stage after him. So it's a John Peel stage from now on.
John was what people think of when they think of Glastonbury. He kind of embodied what Glastonbury, the experience, should be about. So he'd go out and he'd experience all the bizarre and unusual things that were going on and see all the unusual bands and kind of enjoy the whole festival experience.
Actually, this is fair.
You're right, she's right. That's where we are.
The great thing for me with John was that he chose all the best bands, you know, in the early 80s, particularly with the Smiths. I mean, that was the one thing that I got from him. Festival became modern, fashionable place to be at that point.
I like music and I like going to places to hear something that I've not heard before.
I'd always be going, oh my god, it's so good, the Coldplay are headlining on the main stage. And he'd be like, yeah, right, I'm going off to see, you know, Can the Bongo Man.
We've got, for what has been, for me, has been the highlight of the entertainment so far. And you may spot a vaguely familiar face amongst the crowd too. Dancing, I'm told, yeah, dancing. This is the wonderful, magnificent Can the Bongo Man.
John was one of those people who didn't mince his words. If he didn't like a band, then he told you, which is the beauty of him, really.
Also, I'm looking forward to Yes.
Are you?
Yeah, well.
Do you have a relationship with Yes?
No, well, only one of deep and unremitting hatred.
Okay, so John was notoriously a grumpy man.
Girls scramble up on their boyfriend's shoulders, and that means that behind them there's a kind of long V of people who can't see what's going on, and that pisses me off a lot.
And everybody knows that, and everybody loved him for that. I always felt quite protective towards him, because when he was there, he kind of felt quite vulnerable, and he kind of trek off, and you think, oh, I hope he gets back okay. And then he'd come back, I think it was last year, he'd come back with blood dripping down his leg where he'd fallen into a ditch onto some barbed wire.
The low point was about 5 minutes ago, rushing to get to the studio, when I fell into a ditch full of rusty...
Not too wide.
No, I made that mistake yesterday, but there you go.
There was one time when he was rugby tackled by some idiot in the crowd who just kind of took him out.
Could we do something on that?
I think it was affectionate, you know. I don't think it was an affectionate
rugby
tackle. He's
just completely overcome with his adoration for you.
I wouldn't go so far as that, but it did hurt.
I just miss his bulk being there and listening to him talking and being sarcastic about the things that I really like.
Naming the stage after John, I think the family for sure would be pleased anyway. And certainly all the hundreds of thousands of people that come here pleased as well. And I mean, you never know, you know, John might be pleased. If there's life after death, you know, he might be smiling at us, you never know.
We'll be back at 11:35 with live music from Blur, also Ronnie Sizes represent, and there's constant coverage all day long and all night long on Radio 1.
You realise this is the end of the world that we're witnessing here. Good night.
See ya.
Certainly, it was the last time I saw John, I was here last year, and it's kind of strange being without him. I think we can now hook up at the tractor shed, that most luxurious of presenter locations. I think we should be able to join Joe Wiley and Phil Jupiter. So you there, guys.
Well, what do you know? Here we are up on the... we're looking over the Citadel. Welcome along to our little bit of the show. This is the Citadel. This is Glastonbury behind us here now. How's your day been so far?
I had the drive around, as always, the drive down to Glastonbury, quite eventful. I visited on the way down. I always have to stop at home, Stonehenge, and, get vibed up at the Henge. And then,
so you did the Henge thing?
Did the Henge. Myself and Laverne, and then when we arrive on site, I try not to see too many things on a Friday, or indeed be told about them or find out about them, because I'll just sulk because I don't get to see who I want. I had to miss Elvis Costello, which is quite annoying, but I did. I saw the band that we're going to introduce to you very shortly. I saw a big chunk of their set, so I've been set up quite nicely for another brilliant weekend here at Glastonbury.
This has, of course, been one of the most bizarre Glastonbury. I mean, every year you come to Glastonbury and you think, this is quite strange. This has been the strangest. This is the one, the year that Glastonbury virtually went under. I tried to do my radio show this morning. Did a lot of it on the telephone.
Hear things like, oh, there's been some rain. Oh, it's muddy. But when, Lauren Laverne is on the phone in my car and you hear the words, oh, the river has burst its banks. The set is underwater. Yeah, so, it's...
But the great thing, though, about Glastonbury this year is that everyone's so up for it, despite the rain, despite having to kind of wade through seas and lakes to get to see their bands, everyone really, really up for it. And it's not the same. We've just seen this whole film about John, and he's very much missing from our family being here today, and it's kind of really weird doing the show without him. He's always here, though, in our hearts.
I think he's here in the weather as well.
Yeah, definitely love it. Thunderbolt there, lightning there. Enjoy! That's what he's doing at the moment. So Baby Shambles earlier on, they were pretty good. We're going to try and bring you as much live music tonight throughout on the TV show. So we'll try and bring you all the highlights of Ham today. And I think we're going to go over to the Doves now. Or no, we're not going to go over to Doves. I'm trying to think who else. We've got Killers as well.
They're just warming up now down there behind us at the Pyramid Stage.
I have to say, I got down here last night and was walking around, did a whole circuit, which I've never done before. And when people start talking about Glastonbury and all different experiences apart from the music, saw all that last night. Again, we're going to give you a flavour of the different things. The Stone Circle, the Circus Tent, the Kids Field. There is so much going on here, and throughout the entire weekend we're going to show you all of that.
Okay, meantime, let's take a look at the Doves, shall we? We'll be right back. And if you want to keep up with the Glastonbury fun and games over on BBC Three, you can see the Killers set right now if you turn over.
Cannot wait. There's so much anticipation about the Killers coming up. We'll be back tonight on BBC Two, 11 o'clock if you want to join us then, when we'll bring you the White Stripes live. See you then. We're off down there now.